Walk into any store and you're going to be served by clerks and cashiers and salespeople. In restaurants, you're served by a hostess or a server. A receptionist or salesperson serves you at a car dealership, and at a government office, you're served by a clerk or an agent. Now, rarely in all of your dealings with different workplaces are you ever served by a manager, because it's rare that a manager serves the public on the front line. A manager's job is to serve the employee. In fact, let me put it this way. The CEO serves the board and the shareholders. Senior management serves the middle managers. The middle managers serve the employees, and the employees serve the customer. Now, look, I'm not so naive to think that not everyone ultimately serves the customer, but on a day-to-day basis, these are the folks that each level of the organization serves. I think that the real purpose of a good manager has been lost with too many meetings and too much paperwork, and that perhaps it's time that managers change their minds and philosophies of what they are there to do. So here's the tweak. The truth is that managers work for the staff and not the other way around. Staff work for customers. Managers work for staff. Managers work for the staff to provide the staff with continued education, training, coaching, and performance psychology. A manager's job is to help the employee perform better in the job so that the employee might better serve the customer. Managers, your staffers are not only looking for you to help them improve, they are depending on you to help put them in a position where they can move upward in pay and position. So truthfully, if they're not improving, you, the manager, are to blame. You're creating the very turnover you claim to want to stop. Investment yields results, which means that if you're too busy to make an investment of training and coaching of your people, you're going to yield poor results, usually a net loss. I've listened to too many organizations complain that they can't seem to get their employees to engage. And when I ask them how much time they allocate each week in one-on-one coaching and engaging each employee, I get looked at like I'm the idiot. Staff are largely ignored, except for maybe an annual performance review, and managers can't seem to figure out why the employees won't engage. Well, until managers figure out that they are managers, not meetingers, and that the job is to manage, not meet with other managers to complain about how their staff won't engage, this is going to be a recurring problem. Staff will engage in their work when the manager shows up and engages them. One does not magically happen without the other. So how about fewer meetings and more one-on-one engagement? I'm Kevin Burns. Now go build a better workplace.